Hello, everybody. I'm Li Hongbo from Sanyasan University. I'm pleased to give a report about our work on metadata management. I will talk about the background and the motivation. Then I will show the design of grams. At the end of our report, I will give the evaluation. Metadata management is very important in file system, where path resolution is a basic operation in metadata processing. We classify distributed file systems into two types according to the execution method of path resolution. That is client active and metadata server active. And case one is client active. Case two is metadata server active. In case one, client needs to communicate with metadata server to resolve each layer of the requested path. This way makes metadata server easy to scale. Many widely used file systems like Lutter, FAS, PBMS, and SAF use this design. However, this needs to lead to access metadata servers multiple times during path resolution, which brings a lot of network IOs. Case 2 lets a single metadata server to execute path resolution, but also need to resolve the path locally. This way can reduce the network overhead, but cause other problems. Our idea is to still use the client-active method, so as to retain the scalability and reduce the network overhead by overlapping the network I/O in path resolution. The metadata organization decides the way of path resolution. The existing way of metadata management is tree-based, which keeps the access pattern from root to leaf. They use the load name or the load flow path to index the metadata in the tree. In order to overlap the network overhead in path resolution, we should eliminate the dependencies between parent item and child item in the namespace tree. Inspired by graph process, we introduce the graph-based method to organize metadata. Here, we store the namespace as edges and vertexes. Edge storage manages the main metadata, and vertex storage manages the name information of the sub-item. Our system is graphs. In graphs, we index the metadata by the edge. Since each edge is independent, when we look up the path, we could resolve the target path in parallel, different from the tree-based way which should resolve the path layer by layer. Our concurrent path resolution can reduce the latency by overlapping the network overhead in distributed file system. Benefit from the design of edge storage. The path resolution can be performed in parallel. We illustrate the process of concurrent path resolution in this page. It mainly consists of three steps: locating edges, getting edge information, and matching paths. The first step is to find the edge server where each edge is located. The second step is to get the edge information in parallel. The third step is to match the path on the client side by using the edge information obtained in the second step. This step is needed because the edges with same name generally exist in namespace tree. Locating edges and matching paths are done in memory, and getting edge information overlaps the network overhead. So the overhead of path resolution in graphs is relatively small. Here, we show the results of the preliminary evaluation of grams. Our result shows the latency of lookup in grams can be controlled at a constant value. Because grams use a concurrent path resolution method, the edge in grams includes the information of upper directory. So we compare the rename operation overhead. Our result shows the overhead of rename is close to the tree-based file systems. I guess the rename overhead in grams is smaller than the full path indexing system, such as LocalFS, because it would affect more sub-items. when changing the name in a namespace tree. Thank you for listening. If you have any question about my report, you can email me. Thank you.